Hello friends, today in this tutorial I will be telling you that how to make a very simple YouTube video search example in React JS. So here for example, if I type any sort of keyword here, let's suppose sports talk, and if I enter it, you will see a video will be popping in. This is similar to youtube.com structure. So here this video will play, and these are the suggested videos which are there inside this video list component. This is a separate component, this is a separate component. So this is a separate component also, this is search component. So basically there are three components which are there inside this React.js application. So if I click on this play button, this video will play. And these are the suggested videos. If I click any of these videos, let's suppose if I want to click it, this video will pop in inside this newly created video component. So whichever video that you want to watch, you will click this and this playing icon will come. So you can do this with any search item. Let's suppose I change this search terms to Coding Siksha. This is my YouTube channel. So if I do this, you will see this set of videos will come. For some videos, this portion will not come. This totally depends upon the API response that you are getting. So if you check the console here, you will see this object has been returned by the YouTube Data API, which we are making a simple GET request. So these five videos are returned to us. And inside the snippet, we are getting all this information: channel ID, channel title, description, publish time, publish at. Also, we are getting the thumbnails as well. Also, we are getting the title as well. So you can see that. So this is applicable for every video. So every video contains this information. So as I already told you, we are using the official YouTube Data API version 3. So if you search on Google YouTube Data API version 3, so the very first result which comes in, click on this link. This API is totally free. If you are not paying it, so you are free to use this API. Just one thing that you will need is the API key. So API key is very much easy. You can just go to Google Developer Console if you want to sign up for this API. So every Google API requires a API key for tracking your users. So go to Google Developer Console, create a developer account, and after creating that, you need to go to the credentials option. So to create your own API key, so go to your credentials option, and here you will create your own API key. So click on this plus icon, create credentials, and select the API key option. So it will create your own newly created API key. So this will be different for you. So just click on the copy button to copy the API key. That's it. So this is all that you need to do in order to get the API key. Now let me just repeat this process. Type here React and you will see these videos will come. So we will be building this simple application. All the source code of this video is given in the video description. If you want to download the source code, you can go to my blog here, which is given in the video description. Step by step instruction is there. All the source code is there. Click on the copy option to copy all the source code. So go to the video description and go to this blog. You can follow along with the video as well for better understanding. So let's get started, guys, by building this application from scratch. Now to get started, guys, first of all, you need to go to a website which is called as codesandbox.io. So I will be using this website to create the React.js project. So first of all, you need to create an account, log in with your GitHub account, and then click on the new sandbox option and select the technology. So I will use React here. So this will fastly create your React.js project without having to locally build the environment. So it will save you time. So now you can see that this is your brand new React.js project. On the right hand side, you will see the output instantly when you type the code. So the very first thing that we will do is that we will add the dependency. The only dependency that we will need is that Axios. So Axios will be a HTTP wrapper where we will be sending the HTTP request to the YouTube Data API. So install this dependency. It will install it in the background. So now dependency has been installed. So let me just delete all this code here. We will make a search component first in which the user can type anything and submit that form. So right here, we will inside our source directory. This is our source directory. We will make a new folder, new directory, which is called as components. And right here inside this, we will make a new file. Inside this folder, you will see this option, new file. Create this and The name of the component will be simply search.js. So inside this, from the name itself, the person can submit the form by submitting a certain kind of keyword. So right here, we will first of all import React library from the base library, which is React. After this, guys, we will be making this component, which will be a class level component. Class search extends react.component. Set of curly brackets. Now we will write the basic render method which this component will return. We will return a simple div, let's suppose, for just a testing purposes. We will write the string here, search component. Close the div. So in order to use this inside app.js, we first of all need to import this component. So if you go to my blog here, all the step-by-step instruction is there. So I will highly recommend that you open the blog. So you will see, after you make this, in order to include this, it is pretty simple. You need to import this. So import this line here. So let me just go it and import this component. So import search. And we need to import this from components folder, and then there is a file search. But now this will create an error because it cannot find this. So in order to explicitly tell React that you need to export this, you need to write this statement at last, which is export default, and you need to name your component. I will name it as search. So I need to explicitly tell React. So this statement is very much necessary. Now we can include this component by simply writing search here, search, close the tag. So you will see your search component is ready here. Instead of this text, we need an input field. So right here inside search component, search.js, inside this div, we will make a simple form. So we will have a form tag here. Close the form tag. And inside this form, we will have another div tag. We will give a class to it. So basically, these are CSS classes that we will write, custom CSS. So just write this for now. Let me just create some more space that you can see. So inside this form to controls class, we will have a label. So close the label as well. So the label will be simply search. So if you refresh, you will see your search label is there. After this label, we will have a simple input field. Input type will be text, and that's it. And also we will simply provide some placeholder as well, placeholder text. This will be simply enter search keyword. Close this. And now you will see your input field, enter search keyword. You can see that. So we have included this class here for form controls. So in order to do this, also here inside this input field, we will also be providing an ID to it of video search, so that we can style this inside CSS. So just provide this ID. That's it. Now let me just write these styles. So inside this, your root folder, create inside the styles.css, you need to copy paste the code that I have given inside my blog here. If you drag down, you will find the code. If you drag down, you will see app component styles. So these are all the styles which are necessary. So click on the copy option and go to your like this, delete all the code, paste it. And now you will see your input search field will be styled here. You can see that it will have this box shadow effect also. So simply close this file. That's it. We don't need this CSS anymore. So right here, we will make this functional. So when we submit this form, we need to attach a submit handler. So on submit, there is in React, we have this handler. So whenever the form is submitted, we will make this function, which is this dot on submit. So now we need to make explicitly this function. And also on the input field, we need to bind a on change. So whenever the value has been changed, this is an attribute in React here. So we will make a separate function on this dot on search changed. This is a function that we will make here. That's it. And also we will make another attribute inside this input field, which is value. So whatever the value which will be set. So the value will be set simply by this dot state dot title. So inside our state we will declare this variable. So you will see cannot read property title of null. So this error is coming because we haven't declared the state variable. So this is pretty simple. Right here after our class component we will make our state simply set of curly brackets. So here we will make the title variable, that's it. So this will be empty for now. So whenever the application is launched for the very first time, this is equal to null. So now you can see the label is nothing here. So we are attaching it. So this is two-way data binding, this dot state dot title. Now we need to make this two functions, which is on submit and on search changed. So now inside our render method, not inside render method, outside it, right here, there is a property. We need to make these functions. So first function we will make is on search changed. Basically this will take the event object. This is a arrow function like this. And also we will make our on submit. This will also take the event object. And whenever the form is submitted, first of all we will write this function. We need to prevent the form from auto submitting. So we will make this function, which is event.preventDefault. So this is a built-in function which will prevent the form from auto submitting. So we need to call this, and after that we need to pass a prop, this dot props dot on search. So whenever we make this component and we pass this value, we need to pass the state of the title. So this dot state dot title. And whenever the input field is changed, we will grab the value by simply we will make a variable which will be title underscore title. In order to grab the value, we will get event dot target dot value. So we will get the value. We can also console log it to check if it is working or not. Console log title. And lastly, we can set the state by this dot set state. And inside this, we can set the title to whatever the title which is passed by the user. That's it. So you will see if I type anything here in the console, this title will be repeated here, you will see. So this is all we are getting through this value, which is event.target.value. Whenever the input field is changed here, this function will automatically fire and we will get this value by event.target.value, and then we are console logging it. And also we are setting the state, the title variable, to whatever title that is submitted. So if I just inside this, if I submit here, you will see if I console log this dot state dot title, you will see the title will be equal to whatever title which is set. So if I show here in the console, in order to submit the form you need to press enter. So if I enter it, you will see this dot props dot on search is not a function. So here we need to pass this property whenever we are calling this component. So in order to pass a property, this is pretty simple. If you follow my blog, I have shown you how to do this. If you go to my here I have created this. So just wait. So here we are calling this. So here we need to provide this property here, this function. Let me just bind this. So where I am, so pass this on search, this dot on search. So if I just now enter it, you will see it is not a function. We need to define this function first of all. So in the next tutorial we will write this method. Now guys, we will make this function, which is on search, which we are passing here as a JSS attribute here. You will see, first of all, in order to make this function, we need to convert this functional component into search, into class level component. For that, we need to change this to export default class app, and which will extends react.component, the base level component class. That's it. So now it becomes the class level component, so this will not work. We need to have a render method here. So render, so inside render we need to copy paste all this stuff here. So just paste, just change this so that we can use this. So now you can see that it has, we have successfully changed our base app component to a class level component. So now we will define some state as well. So state, so inside the state we will have two variables. So state is equal to a set of curly brackets. So inside this we will have two properties. First is media, video, meta info. So it will contain some information about the video. So this will be an empty array. The second property will be the selected video ID. So basically whichever video has been selected, it will store its ID. So it will be null at the starting. And now we need to make this function, which is on search. So basically just make this function on search, and this will be a async function. So here we will be making the API call, and this will be an arrow function right here. So we will pass the keyword here, so whichever keyword has been there. So inside our search.js we are setting this, you can see that we are calling this function and we are passing this title which is entered through inside this input field. So we are calling this function and we are passing this value, so we are getting this value inside this keyword variable. So after this guys we will make the API call, so we'll make a response variable, and inside this we will use await as this is an async function, and then we will make another component which will be called as YouTube API. So basically it will have, it will make a simple Axios get request to the API. So just write this. So we will make a endpoint which is slash search. So here we need to provide some data. So the data will be simply params. So params is actually the parameter that you need to pass. So Q is the parameter, and we will pass the keyword, actually what keyword has been typed by the user. That's it. So in this file, this is completed. We need to put a set of, I think you need to put this, yes, you need to put this parentheses here. So it will tell you that keyword has been already declared. Let me just see. Let me just see guys what is the problem. There was a simple error guys, we have made this error here. So remove this parentheses here, that's it, this was the error. So now you will not see error. So we just need to create this YouTube API component here. So right here inside your root directory, create a folder. Let me just see the directory structure here. You need to create a folder which is called as API. Inside this you need to create this file. So create a folder, brand new folder, which is YouTube, and inside this, sorry, this needs to be API, not YouTube. So change this to API and create a file which is youtube.js. So inside this file guys, we will make the simple call to Axios in order to fetch the information. Now guys, we will write the simple function in order to call the YouTube API. So first of all, we will import the library which is Axios, which will make this task a little more easier. So import Axios from Axios, we have installed this library, and here just create a new variable key. So this will be the simplest of API key that you got from your Google Developer Console. So if I go to my Google Developer Console, I have already created a API key, so let me just copy paste that API key. So you will see, you just need to copy paste your API key, don't copy mine. Let me just paste it, API key. After pasting it, you need to just make this as export default, because you need to include this component in other components. So export default, axios.create, there is a function inside axios, create. Inside this, this will take some options. First is the base URL. So whatever the base URL that you need to make the HTTP request, this will be https www.googleapis.com/youtube /version3. So this will be the base URL that we will make the HTTP request. The second option it takes is the params. So this will again an object. It takes a part parameter, which is snippet, put a comma. The second parameter it takes is maximum results, which is set to whatever maximum videos that you can set. The maximum value is 50. You can request 50 videos at one time, but I will set to 5. And the next is the actual key. So you will set your API key to the key variable. That's it. This is key. That's it. So this component is ready. And also put a comma here in order to specify any sort of headers. We are not specifying a header, so a empty object. That's it. So this is our Axios component that we have written. Now we need to include this inside our app.js. So simply you need to write import. You can name anything, YouTube API. This name can be anything from the folder name, which is api.api YouTube. That's it. So now you will not see a error which is there. So if I want to see the response which is coming here, if I just console log the response inside this console log response, so you will see if now if I enter any sort of keyword here, coding section, and if I enter it, you will see this dot props dot on search is not a function. Let me just see guys what is the problem. Now guys, if you refresh here, the problem was that I haven't saved my work. So if you create a new file, click on the save option to save your work. So it is pretty much important here inside code sandbox. So now if you save all your work, if you type any sort of keyword, if I type coding siksha, so you will see in the console one entry will be there, an object will be returned to us from the API, which is called as, you can see that 5 items will be there. Each object has its own property inside snippet. All this information will be there. Title, description, thumbnail will also be there. So we will be rendering all this information and displaying this information in form of a result here. So now the search component is working properly. So now what we need to do is that we need to store this information. So go to app.js right here inside this. After console logging the response, we also need to store this information. So in order to store this, it is pretty simple. We need to call a method which is this dot set state. So we will set some of the variables. First variable will be the video meta info. So the video meta info will be equal to response dot data dot items. So basically the array we will be equaling to. The next item will be the selected video ID. So here what we want to do is that we only need to pick the first video in the item. So response dot data dot items. So items is an array, so we will pick the first element, and then there is an ID which is attached to it, ID dot video ID. That's it. So now we have set the state here, these two variables that we declared inside the state. That's it. So now after this, we can even say console log this dot state. And let me just uncomment this line here. So now if I type anything here, let's suppose coding siksha. So inside the console, you will see this object will be set here. Video meta info will be equal to the array here, array of videos which we have got. And in the selected video ID, it is saying to us undefined. For search, some search terms, it will be undefined. But if you search, let's suppose sports truck, enter, and now you will see this is a selected video ID. You can see that it both the variables are successfully set. Now we just need to update the user interface by using these variables. So our search component is ready. Now we get to the next component, which is video list. We need to print the videos inside a form of a list. So what we want to do is that we need to create another component inside our components folder. So just go to your components folder, and right here you need to create a new file here which will be create a file which will be video list dot js. So inside this file, so I will just copy paste all the code because this video will be pretty long if I write this code manually. So copy this code, guys. So copy this code, paste it. So we are taking the actual data which is passed to this component and also on video selected. So when you select any sort of individual video, we will make another component which will be video component. So right here inside this components folder, create another component which is video.js, and the code is pretty simple. If you track down, this is a code. Copy this code and paste it. So you will see all this code will be there inside my blog. Copy paste it. So we are attaching some CSS styles as well: background image, background size, background position, height, position relative. So here inside this, we also need to make a separate folder inside our source directory called as styles. And inside this folder, we need to create a file which is this underscore video.css. So inside this file, we need to copy paste the individual styles for a particular video. So if you drag down, you will find that video component style. So click on the copy button and you need to paste the styles like this. And now after this, we need to include this video list component inside our app component. So import video list from the components folder, and there is a file which is video list. And now we just simply need to include this. So if you include this, you will see video list, and we need to pass some properties to it. So on video selected, this is the attribute that we are passing here. So this will be equal to this dot on video selected. So this function we need to make, and the next data property that we are passing here. So the data will be simply the items array. So we have stored this data inside of a variable which is this dot state dot videos meta info. So this is a variable. Close it. And now we need to make this function on video selected. So whenever you pick any sort of video, you need to, if I type anything here, if I type coding siksha, enter it, you will see inside our suggested area all these videos will be printed out. If I drag down, you will see, if I just see here, you will see all these videos will be there. It will be printed out. And now if I select any sort of video here, on video selected is not a function. So we need to make this function inside this component app.js. So right here we need to make this. So on video selected. So this will be a function simply. It will take the video ID of whichever video has been selected. And this will be an arrow function. Simply we need to set the state, this dot set state. So we need to set the state of the variable which we have inside the state, which is selected video ID. So selected video ID will be equal to the video ID which is passed. That's it. That's the only change that you need to make. And now what you will see, if I type sports book, enter, you will see, if I click on this option in the console, let me just see, you will see this object. And now to play this video, we also need to a separate component which is video player. So we need to make this component. Now the last component is remaining, guys. Inside your components, just create a new file which is video player. So inside this, this will be the actual player file which will be responsible for playing the video. So right here, we, as you go to my blog here, I have given the code here which is there, video player, you can see that. So click on the copy option, copy this code and paste it here inside this file. And now to include this app.js, go to it and import this component video player from the components folder, and the file is video player. And to include this, right here you will write here video player, and if you just do this you will see search for a video has been included. So it will take some attributes that we need to pass inside this component. First of all, it will take the video ID that you need to play. So video ID will be equal to our state variable, which is this.state. Selected video ID, that's it. This is the only thing that it takes, that's it. Now if I refresh, hopefully this application is complete. If I type again sports duck, you will see this is a video. If I change this, if I change to this, you will see it will also change. If I just change this to, you can see that. Now this is a functional application, guys. You can even play the video, but I will not play it due to copyright. So if I change this to my channel, let's suppose Coding Siksha, then in that case I can play because this is my own channel. So you can see this is a functional application. If I click on the play button, the video will play. So in this way, guys, we have built a complete YouTube video search application in React.js using Axios library, and that's it. And also we are using YouTube Data API version 3. So all the source code will be there inside my blog. Copy paste all the source code. And thanks very much for watching this video. Please like the video, share the video and subscribe the channel and hit the notification bell icon. And I will be seeing you next tutorial.